another episode of the Front Three podcast with myself, Big Will, Coach Dan, and of course, the one and only, the prodigy himself, AJ. Gents, how are we feeling? How are we doing?
No, I'm good, boys. I'm good. How are you? What's wrong with your hair?
Nothing. It's a dandruff. Looking for sweet boy like me can never get dandruff. Come on, man.
Put your brush on your dandruff.
Making sure the viewers know that the prodigy's looking sweet and that, you know what I mean? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nah, I'm good. I'm good. How are you?
I'm all right, sir. I'm ready to get popping with this debate.
Good.
AJ, but people got to do something before we start.
My people, it's me again. Here to encourage you guys to please don't forget to comment, like, share. And also, by the way, why don't you just subscribe to our YouTube channel? What about that? How about that? Is that okay? Thank you for subscribing.
Love that. So in today's episode, we're only a few days away from the start of the Premier League season. And we're going to do a mini preview. But we're going to do so by looking at where we think the Big Six will finish this season. So the Big Six are, of course, Arsenal, Manchester United, Man City, Liverpool, Chelsea and Tottenham Hotspur. Who's going to finish? So we start from sixth or first? Which one do you want to go for, gents?
I think more or less we know who top two are. So let's start bottom up.
Fair enough. Who's going to finish sixth this season, AJ? In your opinion. Humble opinion.
It's techie. I'll say Man United, though.
Ooh.
Yeah, I think they'll finish six. Only because I think from what I've seen of them so far in preseason, how Ten Hag has been moving and playing with them, they look a very good opposition. But I just feel like there is still a lot more work that needs to be done. So over the course of the season, we'll see them improve, but I think they might struggle at the start, and then which will hinder the opportunity of finishing in the top four, if that makes sense. Again, the question marks about Ronaldo, whether he's staying or not. The bottom line of it is a guy can guarantee 20 goals. Now, in any team, if someone can guarantee 20 goals, you've got a chance of getting into the top four. Whether he stays or not tilts that dramatically for me personally. Mm. You also have players coming back into the fold, like Martial, for example. We don't know what he's going to do. Preseason's looked electric. But come first game of the season, come a cold night in December, will he produce the goods? Do you know what I mean? I still feel like defensively, there are still some questions to answer for Man United as well. And also in the midfield, of course, signing of Eriksen is great. And you look at that creative aspect that he will bring him alongside Bruno. But then you look at balance. How will they balance that midfield? Is he going to have one anchor? Is he going to have two anchors? Is it going to be... Do you know what I mean? So I think those are little things that Ten Hag will have to work out during the season as well. And that's why I just don't think they'll do top four this year. I think they'll finish sixth.
Okay. Coach?
Sixth position, yeah. Yeah. I think Tottenham
and
will finish.
You can't say Fulham because they're not part of the Big Six.
Not yet. Give us one season. Yeah. Give us one season.
Just one.
You might not sign anyone right now.
I think Tottenham. And you know that's actually going against what everyone else is saying, in the sense that you know, this is tough. This is tough actually. I'll tell you now, yeah. Fifth and sixth. I think it's between Tottenham and Arsenal. Those are the two teams. And it's weird. I'm saying Tottenham, yeah, but here's sort of the reason I'm saying Tottenham. Okay. Tottenham have made decent signings, yeah? And I think that's where a lot of pundits and football people think they're going to... In fact, I think someone even said they're going to finish ahead of Liverpool.
Huh?
One of these guys.
Who?
I'll need to find out and let you know.
Maybe
I'll post it
yesterday.
Exactly. And I don't get it as to why they're making those comments, because Tottenham's made signings. But let's not sit here and think, you know, they've signed some world beaters. Tottenham's not signed any world beaters.
That's true.
They haven't signed anyone of the caliber that, you know, you think are going to come in and hit the ground running.
Quickly, a word of Richarlison. What's your sort of...
I like Richarlison. Yeah. I like Richarlison, but...
I heard somewhere that someone was saying, oh, he carried Everton. He didn't carry Everton.
He didn't carry Everton. No, he didn't. Everton, and if that's him carrying Everton, they've been shocking, so you probably...
Yeah, let's put some things into context
yeah,
here.
Yeah, I heard
he
that.
He was the only forward player who offered something.
That's it.
Look, but Richarlison is good. Yeah. I think Richarlison is good. I think he's going to be Everton. Very good. He's going to be very good, yeah, for Tottenham.
Jamie Carragher, though.
But I don't think he's going to be that kind of player that makes the difference between them finishing outside of the top four and getting into the top four. I don't think it is him.
Does he start ahead of Kulusevski?
I mean, they did make the top. What's that?
Does he start ahead of Kulusevski or not?
Not by how that guy's played.
No.
Not by how Kulusevski's played. I think he's been very good.
Yeah.
He's someone that surprised me when he came to the EPL, man. Yeah. His performance has been phenomenal. I'm a big fan of his. He happened to be a big fan of your club, but he's at Tottenham. so I go for Tottenham sixth because of the players that they brought in. I don't think they're great players. Okay. They're very good. I don't think they're great. But they have a great manager. Okay. And that's the only thing. Yeah, that's the only thing that I'm a bit unsure about.
They tend to do well in league football, doesn't he?
They have a manager who knows how to get things done.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. In contrast to Arteta, yeah, I think Arteta, he's been an assistant to a team or to a manager, yeah, who knows how to win things. Mm. That doesn't necessarily mean he knows how to win things, you know, or knows how to cross the line. Mm. Last season was testament to that.
Yeah.
They had no excuse to have finished outside the top four. They had no excuse.
Thank you.
am I bringing back old? Am I aggravating old wounds? Yeah, sorry, man. So that's the thing. But I think, yeah, players like bringing in, to be fair, the only player they've brought in that I think makes a big difference for them is Gabriel Jesus. Yeah, I think he's phenomenal. I think he's gonna. People will be shocked here. Yeah? Maybe I'm losing my mind. I think here he plays consistently as a forward. He will score between 15 and 20 goals.
I 100% agree.
I think he can do that. I think he can. You know, but then everyone else they've brought in. You think about Vieira. It's a lot of money spent on someone that's going to be on the bench. Zinchenko, if what's the guy's name?
Tierney.
If KT is fit, I think KT starts ahead of him.
Mm.
But that's just me. Maybe he has other plans of where he wants to play
Saliba
him.
Saliba is one to watch this season.
I think he's one to watch. I think, you know what? They're going to find a way to let that guy play. I'm a big fan of this. Yeah. But then again, I don't think he's going to transform Arsenal's defence. I think Arsenal will still be that team, yeah? They'll concede two goals and score three maybe, or, you know, they'll look like they're going to win, but then concede a silly goal. I still think they have that in them because their midfield, I still think they're missing someone in that midfield. I don't think Xhaka, Partey, and Odegaard. That's their strongest three. I don't think they are that formidable. I don't think so at all. And, you know, there's a talk of Tielemans coming. I don't think he's going to change that for them either.
Mm, wow.
So you're going fifth Arsenal, sixth Tottenham?
Yeah, toss a coin.
Okay.
So you think Manchester United will finish in the top four?
I think so.
So AJ, who are you going in terms of fifth?
So United sixth, Arsenal fifth.
Okay.
I think Tottenham will make top four because of the manager. I think if you watch all of Conte's teams that he's achieved with, he's never had a star player because he gets them to buy into unity. And I hear you always saying about they haven't had no world beaters, but they've got two world beaters in their team.
Yeah, yeah.
And Kane and Son. And that is the difference. Kane and Son and Conte. That three.
That's why I can't see them finishing six.
I feel like I see them finishing top four.
I get it.
But they are an injury away from all of that being...
You know what I'm saying? Those two are phenomenal. I think those two get... I've said it before, elsewhere, if not here.
Yeah.
That those two walk into any team in Europe. I think so.
Yeah.
I really believe so. So that's what they've got ahead of, so like Arsenal and stuff. But I think overall, Arsenal has a better team. Mm. I think Arsenal's starting lineup. I'll pick Arsenal's starting lineup ahead of Tottenham's starting lineup. By Harry Kane and Son.
Okay, that's interesting stuff.
Personally, I'll go for Man United in six.
Yeah.
I'd say. And then fifth, it might shock you, in Chelsea. I think it'll be close, but I think Chelsea.
That doesn't surprise me, only because of watching that.
Yeah, look.
Do you know the reason why? When he first said it, I was like, this guy's lost his mind. Then I just thought, then do you know what hit me? I'm looking at the squad right now. There are gaps that need to be filled. And there are players who are there right now who haven't fulfilled their potential.
Werner looks like he's going to go and learn to somewhere else. Juve.
Ziyech hasn't really
Newcastle.
Lit it up. Mm. Pulisic still looks like a young boy in the Premier League. He looks like a schoolboy. He looks like a year seven player of the 11s. Do you get what I'm saying? The way he gets handled. Lukaku's now gone. You look at the striking options. Doesn't fill you with much confidence.
The way they Havertz plays in there,
but
well,
Havertz
great.
Plays in there. He scores some big goals, but can Havertz go on to score 20 goals this season? Mm. Then you look at, okay, brought Raheem in, so he can guarantee you something. But who's playing on the other side that will match Raheem's output or do something a bit different? You're struggling to connect that. You look at their midfield. I think their midfield personally is solid. And also with Gallagher coming back. Then defensively, there's holes. Aspie's going to leave. Okay, we have Reece James there, but do we have good enough cover? You look at the three centre-backs that they normally play with. You know, Christensen has now left. So you've got, you know, Rudiger's also gone. So there's huge gaps. Koulibaly's come in. But, you know, we all know about what the Prem is like. Come on, you come in the Prem. Some people think they'll hit the ground running. the Prem gives you the shock of your life, and all of a sudden your form's being questioned, and do you know what I'm saying? So there's parts of the jigsaw that
it might change if Chelsea, you know, after
sign someone between the next few days, of course. Yeah. But also whoever they sign, is unless they sign from other Premier League clubs, and we're talking like top players at their current club, whoever's coming has to adapt. And we know how long that takes.
Well, you know, before we start this, I was saying, I don't think there's anyone anywhere in world football, that Chelsea can bring in, that, let's say, will challenge Liverpool and City and Liverpool. Mm-hmm. I don't care who you bring in. Mm-hmm.
So you're saying fifth place for Chelsea is not a bad shout at all. Do you know what I mean? But I just think...
based on how we are...
I think it's a bit blasphemous, but...
but I just think, I think
Tottenham finishing sixth is... I can't see it.
Fair enough. But no, it is a good point. To be fair, I might have to revisit that. Maybe 15 games in. No, because think about it, Harry Kane and what's his name, Son.
And he didn't have a great season last year.
Exactly. They're going to score at least 20 goals each.
They're going to be on smoke this season.
I think they're going to score 20 goals each. Yeah. And they're that good.
Guys, after those runs Conte is making them, do you think they're not going to settle for anything less than top four? Nah. Bro, they have to. They will die on the line for top four.
I think I'm only making that I'm only saying what I said, yeah? Because I don't think the players they've brought in, yeah, incredibly improves them as a team.
I can't see how they're not better than Manchester United, though. That's my...
I think that's the... I'm going to say it right now again. Oh, you know what? You know, finish your thought. Maybe you finish your thought about what you were saying about sixth and fifth. Then...
I think it's United, Arsenal.
Okay.
Arsenal fifth, United sixth, Tottenham fourth.
Okay.
I'm going Arsenal fourth, Tottenham third.
Okay. I think... Tottenham fourth. Yeah, Tottenham fourth. It's just a Conte effect. I just feel like with him, like I said, his teams have never had guys who are, you know, do you know what I'm saying? And that's how he works. That's what he loves to work with. Players who have, you know, Kane and Son, we take them aside. They're incredible footballers. And so with the rest, it's about buying into unity, buying into his philosophy. We're dying for each other. You know,
don't forget they got Bissouma now as well in that midfield.
And I think he's the only one that really gets into the first team.
Yeah, he's of the players they brought in. Though. He's building a good squad, a squad that will be competitive. You know, I look at their bench now and I'm like, ooh, okay.
Tottenham, they can bring some people off the bench.
You know, because we're still forgetting, he's still got the likes of Lucas Moura. Yeah. These are players with pedigree. Do you get it? So, but I just think Conte puts Tottenham into my top four 100%.
Yeah.
Just Conte.
Yeah.
And then it's Arsenal, United. Yeah, the rest.
You know... so, I put United fourth into the top four. For as long as I still have breath running in my system, in my body, I am not going to sit here and condone people that say United don't have a good team.
No, they do.
I cannot condone
that. Their squad on paper is mad. We know that. But it's a translation from paper to pitch.
Listen.
No, I just think Fred, McTominay...
okay, they've got you Maguire. Keep Fred and McTominay there and Maguire, and you look at Bruno Fernandes, Christian Eriksen, Jadon Sancho, Cristiano Ronaldo. Fam,
my friend, we need to stop that. I think United have been riding on that thing for that way for way too long. You get even people, big players have played, you know, at that club previously saying they don't have it. United have a phenomenal team.
100%.
I'll give you this. I think their two holding midfielders can be better. I think, you know, with Pogba leaving especially, they need to find someone.
Defensively, yes, Varane. Martinez is not untested in the Premier League, so you're not sure about that. The fullbacks, okay, but they're not... are there anything better than what Tottenham have?
It depends which fullback you're talking about.
If we go to right back...
if you go to right back, Wan-Bissaka, you can say whatever you want about him, he's a different kind of fullback. If you're expecting him to bomb up forward, like, you know...
Doherty.
This means not... This is not a shot at him or anything like that, but let's be serious.
Dallow's better than all of these men we mentioned. And I don't even think Dallow's cold. I think he's all right.
Exactly. My point was this, though, I think they hold... it's weird because they hold, Wan-Bissaka a different standard to the kind of player he is. People expect him to be up there whipping in crosses for his striking teammates to get at the end of. He's not that kind of player. That's why when you look at numbers, no one beats him going backwards. No one beats him. He's that good going backwards, Going forward, he doesn't have that in him. Why can't he just be that kind of player, that is solid at the back and can keep help retain possession, but it doesn't necessarily have to rip in crosses. He doesn't have to have 15 assists in a season. He's just not that player. But Luke Shaw, I think he's got bags of talent. He just needs consistency. They've brought in this new kid now.
And Shaw is better than Sessegnon.
I just don't think they have anyone in the midfield that can really like dictate a game.
Yes, this is what I'm saying. I think Fred, and McTominay, you can do better than those two. Because right now, those are the two strong, right? Or maybe, who knows, Van den Beek can rediscover himself, right? But with, and of course, you know, we can talk about rediscovering themselves in the sense of Martial, Rashford, and Sancho himself. But from what we've seen during preseason, and you can
say, how much stock do we put in preseason?
You can say whatever you want about preseason. Preseason is very important. Let's stop that. People like to say that preseason is important.
Saying, like, how much
stock when the season's. Yeah. My point is this, you take preseason to rediscover yourself, right? The same way you take preseason to get your fitness, you take preseason to rediscover yourself.
How much do we put into it? I'm just thinking players can perform when there's no pressure.
Who says there's no pressure?
In preseason.
Have you seen these preseason games? Preseason games?
I think it depends on the club you're at. For somewhere like Man United, there's pressure because a new manager's coming. That means that you want to impress and you're fighting for a shirt, basically. Someone like Marcus Rashford, for example, there's pressure on him to deliver the season. Whether he likes to admit or not, there's pressure on him
to deliver.
Jadon Sancho. There's pressure on Jadon Sancho to deliver because of his price tag and the fact that he was arguably one of the best wingers in the world when he was at Dortmund.
Will,
there's pressure. When Anthony Martial, top teams. Bro, Anthony Martial, the pressure that's on that brother. Listen, I was having this conversation the other day, Anthony Martial came to England, they was in the next Henri. What kind of blasphemous nonsense. He's got to prove that. He's got one speck of Henri in him. Do you know what I'm saying? So for Man United, for me, especially those young boys, not even young anymore, to be honest, those guys there in that front line area, there's pressure on them to deliver.
But look how well Arsenal played in pre-season. Are we then saying that, are they going to finish in the top four?
Well,
top
Chelsea three?
I never really touched on Arsenal why I think, maybe I did, but not to the extent that perhaps would have answered your question yet. This is why I think though Arsenal will finish outside the top four, is because with the philosophy of let's build for the future, well then that's exactly what they're going to do. They're going to always be building for the future. They've not brought in anyone, apart from Gabriel Jesus, who's a winner. He's tested and proven in the EPL.
Zinchenko.
But he'll contribute. But I don't really class him as a massive contributor to what City's done in the last few years. I wouldn't say so. He will contribute. Don't get me twisted. He's better options, in midfield and at the back than what they currently have coming on. I'll say that right now, because I think he's a very good footballer. But I'm saying to say this, William Saliba is good. You know, Saka is good. Yes, Martinelli is good. They've given these boys numbers as players who'll be starting. Martinelli will not get Arsenal into Champions League.
Okay. It's the severity of how he said it. Hey,
William Saliba will not get Arsenal into Champions League. Edin Ketia won't get Arsenal into Champions League.
Famous last words.
With these talks, you have to have a good mix, of very, very talented footballers like they do in Emil Smith Rowe, in Saka, in Martinelli, in these Edin Ketias, and you have to mix them with very seasoned, top professionals.
Who have one thing.
Shaka isn't one of them.
Of course not.
Nah. And
Partey doesn't play 15 games in a row in a season.
And it's true what he's saying about, only Jesus and obviously Zinchenko coming in have won things in the Arsenal squad. And we're talking about winning things of, bro, come on, not Audi Cups and stuff. We're talking about winning serious stuff. Do you know what I'm saying?
But and I guess Arteta's and Arsenal's point of view is Saka's going to step up another level.
Everyone's going to step up a level.
Martinelli, I guess that's what they're...
When they said, you can't win anything with kids, right?
That's my thing.
There's truth in that to a degree, because you've got to have people who are seasoned and have won things around you. You look at the Chelsea team. Bro, that team is full of international winners and winners. Do you know what I'm saying? And that's why I'm saying, you know, you saying they're going to finish fifth, I hear it, but for me, the reality is they won't because they've got winners in that camp.
He
people
says
who
fourth.
Won things. Sorry, four,
fifth.
No, he said fifth.
Yeah.
Oh, fifth. Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? And that's the subtle differences. Man United, as much as we go on and say, I've said, you know, they'll finish sixth and stuff, they've got proven winners in that team.
They've got, United's got a top team. And on top of that as well, they've got a manager who knows how to win. Not only in Holland, yeah, but in Champions League as well, because he done really good in Champions League. Mm. I think that also makes a big difference. I think now they've got a manager, yeah, who knows what he's trying to do with the team, yeah? And, you know, you hear all these comments about, oh, they're fitter now and blah-de-blah. I think that, you know, we get caught in those moments.
Yeah,
it's like, what? So the other manager didn't care that his players were fit?
Yeah.
It's not the point. You know, he's giving them new ideas that the players believe in, you know? Yeah. It's about, let's play football a bit more now. And I think the players just love, you know, it's been very good. I think, you know, a few of the players are rediscovering themselves and that could only bode well for them. So that's why I have them in my top four.
Okay, so who's finishing third for you?
Chelsea.
Okay. So top two is either going to be City or Liverpool. AJ, who's going to be number
you
one?
Can't sign Erling Haaland. And I think for me, it's just as simple as that. I think we've seen City over the last years play without a recognised striker and rack up the numbers that they have. Mm-hmm. Now just imagine that freight train with that hammer left foot. Bro, it's got to be curtains this season. Mm. And I don't think it will click straight away. I think there will be a few, you know, but yeah, City for me will finish top. And then I think Liverpool second and then I got Chelsea third as well.
I had Chelsea third, yeah? Okay, fair enough. I'll tell you this. When people start, you know, submitting their predictions, yeah, City will be always first.
Yeah, of course.
And I think I get why. They have top manager, the best players, the brand of football they play. They've won the league twice in a row now,
yeah.
Is it?
Mm-hmm.
I still think Liverpool is the best team in the country. How about this? I think Liverpool is still the best country in the world. And that's why I always have them first to win. And before I turn it over to you guys,
I think Liverpool are the best country in the world.
Is that what I said?
Yeah. We've got to quote that.
Listen, in fact, yeah, they can have their own country. How good they're playing, they can have their own country.
Oh,
I think Liverpool is the best team in the world. Correction.
Okay.
Let me make this this point.
Even
quickly.
With the loss of money.
Yeah. Because you know why? I think they replaced him very well
with Diaz.
Mm. I think Diaz is a phenomenal footballer.
100% agree.
I mentioned Diaz time ago. You know what's funny? Yeah? I remember saying, yeah, I think two players that Liverpool, yeah, really need. Douglas Luiz from Villa and
Diaz,
what's his name?
Diaz.
And they got Diaz. Maybe they're working for Douglas. But Jurgen says they're four. They don't need any more players.
Yeah, he said they're not sending no one.
I think they've got a very good replacement in him. I wanted to make this comment, yeah? Because, you know, with Haaland coming to the EPL, we think he's going to smash it. We've made comments like that. Everyone believes so. So you ask yourself, why? Why do we say that? And it could only be because, you know, in Bundesliga, he's been phenomenal. Since he stepped in the field, he's been phenomenal. But you see, whenever I find myself in an argument, yeah, let's say about Lewandowski, immediately people make the argument, oh, but he's scoring all those goals in Bundesliga.
Mm.
Or, yeah, that's the argument we make, right?
Mm.
Why is it that, yeah, for him, we try and justify it or make light of the situation of how good he is, yeah, that he's playing in Bundesliga, but in the same breath, we think Haaland will do good in the EPL, even though he's coming from the Bundesliga.
No, but remember, I mentioned the Champions League. Whenever he plays for Dortmund,
I hear what you're saying.
Lewandowski smashed it.
Yeah, exactly. So
don't get me twisted. I'm not saying that to say he's not going to smash it, because I'm one of the people that said he's going to smash it.
Yeah.
But it boggles my mind that people can, you know, we can move the goalposts to make arguments like that. I think he makes a very big difference. I think you mentioned your mate think, you know, he might come in and come out or something
like
that. I don't think so. He's the only recognized striker they really have now.
His injury history.
It's a couple of years now. Yeah. He's been.
Yeah, it's not been.
It's been really bad. Yeah.
We'll see how it bodes. But I think that argument, about people saying, oh, it's because it's the Bundesliga. No, for me, numbers don't lie. You still have to put the ball in the back of the net.
Other strikers playing in the Bundesliga.
It doesn't matter if you're playing a farmer 1 week and then, do you know what I mean? Yeah. Or whoever next week, you still got to put the ball in the back of the net. I remember when Neymar was first coming through and people were like, oh, he's not all that because he's at Santos and it's the Brazilian league. Like I kept on saying, everything he's doing, he actually has to do it, and he does do it. So you can't tell me the brother's not talented and he's not pulling up trees because it's the level of the league.
Yeah.
I think he'll do very well. You know, I was saying Jesus will score between 15 and 18. I don't see why this guy can't hit between 20 and 30.
Yeah. I do feel they'll miss Sterling. They'll miss Jesus as well, because if you look at the back end of last season, he was a very important player. Played 100%. All the big games, if you remember correctly, yep. as well.
Yep.
So they'll miss that as well. Defensively, I'm a bit concerned. I don't know if there's enough cover for them.
Mm.
If they do get, obviously, the Brighton.
I haven't seen much of John Stones this preseason, so I don't know what's going on with him.
He didn't end the season well as well, and he's injuries.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's injuries.
I think maybe he just gave extended break to the English boys. I don't know how much.
How do you feel Calvin Phillips will do?
Mm. Interesting signing.
I don't know if they needed him.
I think they... I don't know. It depends what you mean by they needed him. But
they needed to replace Fernandinho.
But listen, Pep Guardiola builds a team. You know what I'm saying? He builds a team.
Mm.
This is what I'm talking about. Yeah, he's a manager that knows how to win, and so he does everything that leads him towards to winning.
That's true.
Let me make a quick contrast here, because we were talking about how Arteta came from Pep.
Yeah.
We know Phillips is not going to be starting lineup. Yeah, if all his players are fit, Phillips won't be starting lineup. But guess what? If Rodri's out, Phillips is the one that fills in. I think Phillips is a better player than what Arsenal's bought so far.
I wouldn't disagree with you.
Arsenal's brought in, let's say that kid, Vieira. Guys.
Okay, but let's not, because in a few years' time, he might be.
See, we're speaking nonsense. Yeah. When we say that's not an argument.
But I don't...
But Phillips, we're talking about next season.
Yeah.
Phillips is a better option coming off the bench for City than anyone else Arsenal's got. Than Elneny.
Oh, yeah.
Arsenal's got.
That's not even a question, to be fair.
How about this? I'll prefer Phillips, next to Partey than Xhaka. How about that?
Yeah, 100%.
Absolutely.
And that's my point. Yeah. That's my point, exactly.
Yeah.
You don't go and spend your 35 million on a kid that might be good. He's good. Yes, he's good. But I don't think he's going to come starting lineup. And I don't think he's going to play 15 games and set up
so
eight.
So they shouldn't have bought him.
I think they should have invested that money in someone else. 100%. That will produce right now.
Like who?
Tielemans.
He's better than Vieira, I would say. But you know
who
he is.
He's proven in the Prem.
And he cost about the same price.
But then you've just got to look at it from Arsenal's point of view. Do they view him as someone potentially in 3 or 4 years' time that's going to be someone great that they had to get now?
Who's that?
Vieira.
Maybe.
But someone else might get him. So they're thinking, okay,
but Will,
this is more of an investment. Because, teams... teams, they buy plays for next season, for the immediate future. But they also invest in the future.
Let me tell you this. With this Arsenal team that they have, they don't finish in the top four. Yeah?
Okay.
If these youngsters that they're building for 2-3 years' time, let me tell you something now. If Bukari Saka, stays there for 2 years and doesn't move on when Arsenal don't finish in the top four, he's got no ambition. He has no ambition. He's going to move on. Then they'll need to replace him with another youngster. You've got to stop it somewhere. They've got enough top youngsters. You need to build around them.
Yeah.
You need a solid core for them to come up, to raise them.
But let's not digress, though. Sticking on Man City.
He doesn't want to talk about Arsenal, man.
No, because we're going to go too long on this.
No, it's a fair point.
You're saying that Liverpool are the best team. Why?
He's about to write us a disso. Guys, I'll be back. What a question. Of all the people to ask that question, you ask him.
I should not have.
Okay.
You've got 25 seconds.
Okay, in that 25 seconds, how about this? The whole of last year, they lost about 2 games. I think that answer's enough.
But that was last year.
They didn't win anything.
Regardless. Yeah? Don't say they didn't win anything. It's tough. When you get to a final, there can only be one winner. Yes, you've been some.
Well, of course.
Yeah, fair enough.
your point is well made. They lost tickets, but they didn't win the Premier League, they didn't win the Champions League.
No, they didn't. That does not take away the fact that they are the best team in the world. Mm. You look here, when you go, let's say you go pound for pound, as a boxer or whatever. Yeah, you can come up against someone that will sucker punch you, like happened to them in the Champions League. That's what it really was, right? And again, I always make this comment. Maybe I'm joking about it, but I think, again, Gerrard failed Liverpool Football Club. He's got to see that win through. He's got to see that through, but he didn't. Yeah?
But
they lost the least in the league. Guys, this is very important. This is very important. I think, yeah, to go through a whole season, yeah, lose about two or three games. The whole season, they played in every final there is to play.
But then
they played in every final there is to play, Will. Lost the league by a fraction of 5 minutes or 1 point. However you want to look at it.
An indicator of what will happen in the future, though.
Okay, then we can say the same about. But then I can say the same thing about Manchester City. But you would say no. You're basing Manchester City on how well they'll do by history or the past. I'm making my argument based on that as well. And I think one other player, yeah, that Liverpool's brought in and people are a bit, you know, they've got the question mark on, yeah, is Darwin Nunes. I think he'll be very good for Liverpool. You'll be shocked, man. I think he's going to be very, very good.
His movement is so good.
Oh, excuse me. I think he'll be very good for them. And so I don't even think they've... Yes, Mane is phenomenal. Mane is proven. Liverpool legend, whatever you want to call it, in the sense that, you know, after 30 years, he was part of the team that won it and the Champions League and whatnot. But I think Diaz is a very, very competent replacement. Mm.
I think he get is. The amount of goals, though, that Mane...
He doesn't have to get that man, of course. But right now, they've got an out-and-out striker.
Mm. Which gives him a different kind of...
Do you understand?
Whether he hits the ground running or not, we'll
That's
see.
That's the thing.
I think he's got great movement. I think he scored four the other day, a few weeks ago.
Nunes, you mean?
Yeah. And, you know, he looks like he can finish. But, guys, the Prem's a whole different kettle of fish. I always say this. And so we'll see. Mm. I hope he does well for his sake and the price I go over his head.
Yeah, and obviously they've got Jota, but my only issue with Jota, he seems to be getting injured. Too many injuries. At
Pep,
the moment.
Pep, and what's his name? And Jürgen, they don't miss. On their big name signings, they don't miss. They hardly miss.
Really? Who's got an agenda, you know? I'm telling you, who's got an agenda?
I'm telling you something now, though. In his first season, Grealish has not lit the world up at Manchester City. But guess what? He sold Raheem. Grealish is going to play now.
Has to.
He's going
also,
to play.
I remember we had this conversation, you know, about how Mahrez had to adapt to the Pep way and change
his
game.
Yeah, his first year he wasn't phenomenal. Yeah,
that's going to be the same with Grealish. But, hey, let's see what happens.
Same. Yeah, I think.
So you guys think City, top,
Liverpool, second. Chelsea, Spurs, Arsenal, United for me.
Well, that's you. Mine is Liverpool, Manchester City, Chelsea, United. Tournament Arsenal, it's a flip, man. Heads or tail.
Okay, and then just quickly in a minute, who would be sort of your wild card team to possibly break into the
Villa.
Top six?
Top six, yeah? You think Villa?
Villa.
To be fair, after the top six, I don't even know what other teams are
there. West Ham, possibly.
With West Ham, though, I think they're going to need... They've got a good striker now.
Yeah, they've got a good striker.
Very good. The defender they brought in is out now.
Oh, yeah.
He messed himself up. Yeah. I think they'll need a top midfielder. Mm. I think they need to bring in a creative midfielder.
Yeah.
But I don't think your suggestion. I don't think it's bad at all in Villa.
I think Gerrard now has had an extra time with them to kind of implement what he really wants to do and get certain players working a certain way. I look around and it's Villa that stick out for me.
I like West Ham though as well. I think Villa, West Ham.
You know, if there's three clubs, I'd say could be my wild card. It's Villa, West Ham, and Crystal Palace.
Mm.
Those are the three. But out of those three, one that stands out for me is Villa. I just think because of the Gerrard effect and keeping Coutinho and I can just see it being something special.
Yeah, man. I think Villa and West Ham are great shouts. You know what's funny? I can't even remember what teams now.
What do you say about Newcastle? No.
But Newcastle, they've got the funds. I don't think they've brought in any amount of players or quality of players that are gonna
listen, guys. Sometimes in life, doesn't matter how much money you have, you can be very unattractive. I'm telling you.
I think that's the
only when you're Newcastle, mate.
I'm telling you. Hey, Newcastle, that's me. I'm not trying to avoid it. It's just true.
So yes, those are our predictions. What are you?